on Boss Talk 101. Yeah, we gon' talk.
The way that the music moved, man. Then, like I said, when I seen you, I was like, man, did DJ Envy, did he have By Hardaway or what was his
so
deal with that?
So what happened with the DJ Envy situation?
At first, he didn't have, it wasn't, you came off with it first, right?
Yeah, like okay. I dropped it.
Yeah,
like,
you dropped it.
Like, really, I didn't even drop it. Me and my crew, like, we had a copy and we was in a strip club somewhere. And my brother like, man, I'm finna play this shit. He sent it to a DJ. I don't remember who got it first. I want to say it was DJ Big Tiny, maybe, yeah. who we slipped it to first. And then DJ.
What
DJ
was it at? Where was y'all at?
Man, what the name of that club was right there? V-Lot? That shit right there by Talk Golf.
The V-Live was down here? V-Live alone. Yeah, they had the three stories in there. I went in that thing.
Yeah,
they
had the three,
yeah,
folks,
that's right. Yeah, like, yeah, yeah, I seen that,
yeah,
man.
So that's probably one of the first places we dropped that shit. Magic City, for sure, we dropped it there. Like,
wow.
All the major shit, we were just like, once my brother slipped that shit one time, we were like, fuck it. Let's just go out and do it. Like, yeah, it's on. Next thing you know, it started getting big in the clubs, in the streets, niggas running around playing it. DJ Envy came down. My DJ, DJ and Dirty was playing it in 11:45, and the whole club, like, he stopped the music and the whole club was singing and shit. Yeah, like crazy, like whoa, like if I ever dropped a tear about some shit, that was amazing. It was that moment, like
messed them boys head up.
They singing my shit. They screaming,
nigga,
my
that's
shit.
Favor, nigga, that's favor.
You
bro.
Feel me?
That's favor.
And the crazy thing. We go home, like, we weren't even, you know what I'm saying? We were just doing, we had to do the move around to make shit look good.
So you hadn't did the video yet or nothing like
hell,
that?
Nah, hell, nah.
It's just, you dropped
just
it in there?
Just the music was out, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
And DJ Envy called my brother's phone. How did he get his number? I don't know, call. You know what I'm saying? I'm in the room sleep. He coming out like, hey, bro, some nigga named DJ Envy just called me. I talk, what, DJ Envy? He like, yeah, you know who this nigga is? I'm like, bro, stop fucking playing with me.
Love
ain't
you,
no
man.
Fucking DJ Envy call you, nigga. He like, bro, I'm dead ass. I said, man, whatever. I roll over and go back to sleep. He called back. He say, bro, it's a DJ, nigga, DJ Envy. So then he called my other manager and shit. I don't think he believed it either. So I finally got up. Call him back then. He called him. He was like, yo, what's up, Reds? It's DJ Envy. I'm like,
you knew the voice, nigga. That Breakfast Club, nigga.
Yeah,
you hear
I'm
the
saying,
voices.
Hey, you know, I'm still thinking the nigga might be playing, cause you know, at that moment nigga everybody was playing and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, what up? You feel me? He like, yo, man, I like the record, blah blah blah. I'm like, for real. Oh, yeah. 100, appreciate it. How you get my brother number? You know what I'm saying?
Nigga, like, get hard on that nigga,
yeah,
man.
But nah, I'm trying to open him up and see if it's real, like, and it was real, like. I'm
yeah.
like, oh shit. Hey, I called my manager, hey bro, nah, that's him for real, bro. We got the boy, what else? Let go do this shit.
He wanted to do, what did he want to do?
So what we did, I don't know initially what he wanted to do. Maybe he did want to buy the song, but that's something I don't know. I didn't have that discussion. But what happened was, we did like a partnership on the record, 50-50 partnership. And we re-dropped it.
Wow.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? We re-dropped that shit. And it went crazy.
Went crazy, man. I remember seeing Birdman in that damn car. And
that Instagram video right there, that's what let that, I think that's when I knew, like, this shit might be something. Nigga, Birdman right around playing this motherfucker. This might be one.
Man, only you ain't no whole bunch of people experienced this, what you saying, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's dope though that you will you be able to make a song bigger than that?
Will I? Of course.
Have you made a song bigger than that?
I don't think I made it today due to the numbers, but
yeah.
I will. I make plenty more bigger than that.
Remember I asked the same question.
How much pressure do you put yourself under to make something bigger than that?
I don't put myself under no pressure because I honestly feel like God gave me the talent to do it the first time. And I did that song on the spot. Like, it wasn't, I ain't sit down, think about it or nothing. It was like, I went in, did it. And the truth about Hardaway, right? I had did a song already, like, well, at least a hook. I did a hook like years ago. And when he put me on the spot, London playing the beat, and there's a lot of us in the studio, so My manager like, get in there. What you scared of, boy? You know you can go out the top. Get in there, boy. You a jukebox. Just make some.
You
go. I go in there. I'm thinking. Yep, I hit them. They pressing the top button. What taking so long, bro? Say something. So I called my engineer. Done. Salute. You know what I'm saying? Hey, bro. You remember that song I did when I was talking about Magic Hardaway, Penny Hardaway? He was like, yeah. I said, play that shit right quick. So now I step behind the thing in the studio behind it so it don't pick up on the mic. Mm-hmm. I'm listening Hardaway, Hardaway, Orlando Man Hardaway. I bet, boom, I hang up. And I go in there, Hardaway, Hardaway. You know what I'm saying? Trying to make it go to the beat. I ain't nothing with that. And it just came, I'm looking in the room, I'm seeing niggas like, niggas was over there doing all that. I ain't nothing that nigga for now. Like. And to be honest, it was a lot of niggas on Hardaway at first.
Really?
Hell yeah. Like, you know how you do a song in the studio?
Yeah, 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 a lot of people.
And then niggas just boom, 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 put verses on there. It was a lot of niggas on there. I had to wake up, like, one of my buddies like, bro.
Can't do that.
Nah, you tripping, bro. This, you need to do this. You need to go do a second verse, bro. You tripping. Mm-hmm. And I went and did the second verse. And I forgot the studio I was at, but Young Scooter was in there. He was like, this the one. Goddamn, Alibi, this the one. So when all these niggas saying that, I'm like, fuck it, I'ma go on finish it. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But yeah, that shit was lit though. Think about it now. I ain't never thought this deep about Hardaway in that
moment. Man, we went in on that one of my favorite songs. That's all that's happening right here.
I ain't asked now, nigga, for nothing. I took the Hardaway. 12 put me over coming with the dope. They took my Hardaway.